What is your sense? What are you reading in? First of all, the kind of weak data that we have seen come in from Europe, how much of that impact on demand do you really expect?
Well, good morning, Minister. I think it's got to be factored in, and then it's quite severe in the sense of global slowdown. Certainly, Europe's taking the charge on that. 18 was a terrible year when you're looking at, you know, the growth of what we experienced in 2018 for Europe. And 19's not going to be any better. It's actually probably going to be worse. So that really puts a handbrake as far as the demand picture. US dollar, we're also understanding it's had a very strong rally in the last week to the upside. And that's certainly taking the heat out of crude. And that's been a very good short trade over the last week.
Peter, also, how do you read various reports on, you know, Saudi trying to cartelize or rather, you know, involve Russia and some other oil producers for a longer period of time where we haven't seen Moscow really agree to that? That also seems to be putting the prices in red right now.
Well, exactly right, Manisha. There's also a meeting next month in Azerbaijan on the 17th of March that I'll probably attend. Now, that's fairly interesting because you've got the Saudis there, but you've also got the other OPEC producers, some of the other OPEC producers, but the mainstay, of course, is the Russians. Mm. So I think that they're really looking as far as banding together. They're going to try and make this OPEC and the non-OPEC producers a stronger cartel. There's no doubt that they need to really take on board as far as you know, where the price volatility is. And whilst we're happy in the West, and I know India's not happy at the current pricing, but I'm very sure that the producers aren't happy, and you've only got to look at the state of Venezuela to really give you an idea on that.
Oh, absolutely. And one more point that the international markets are watching, or the commodities really are looking at, Peter, is the US and China trade spat, where we seem to be back at square one with the latest US president's statements that he's not willing to meet the China president before until 1st of March. That really seems to be yet another reason that the sell-off that we have seen, not just in crude, but in metals as well.
Well, yes, and you saw it overnight also on the Dow, Manisha, and that's also got to take on board the next couple of days in the sense how that'll wash through the market. I reckon, and we've been talking on this for, you know, the best part of 4 or 5 months, it's been an ongoing concern and nearly to the point it's the same as Brexit, how that's going to work. So I think volatility is going to be quite incredible over the next 6 weeks because of that uncertainty with President Trump and what impact that has. If the deal isn't sought by Easter, which is the 20th of April approximately, then I think that it's going to be a very, very wild ride for that second quarter.
One final quick question, Peter. So is there any recommendation on the buy side, whether it's for crude or metals right now? Or as you said, incredible volatility is something that the markets should be preparing for.
Manisha, I think it's been priced in as far as that US dollar. We're up nearly a cent and a bit, you know, on that US dollar index from 95.4 to around about 96.5 since last Friday. And I feel as though there's more momentum to the upside, not from a rate perspective as far as the Fed, but the uncertainty is, and I think this will be very much absorbed in the market overnight in New York tonight, what impact that has as far as where President Trump, what's happening as far as China. That really spooks the market, because that's the uncertainty that really plays into volatility.